this is a big deal to have this.
Two first-year automation programs are powering a new electronics lab at Pennsylvania College of Technology. The 906-square-foot space is home to about 60 students per semester seeking an automation engineering technology bachelor's degree in either mechatronics or robotics.
It's the cutting edge. I mean, it's robotics. It's assembly line sort of stuff. The hardware with the programs, with the actual physical system that you're working on.
Industry was telling us they liked what our students were doing. They were looking for more because of the growth of, you know, automation in industry. So we really looked at what we already had and then how we could expand on that. And I think when you expand when you're expanding the program, we needed to expand the space. And now that it's done, we thought it was really big. Now that you put stuff in there, I'm like, I don't know if it's big enough.
That stuff includes four KUKA robots featuring vision systems. The machines rely on feedback provided by a camera to complete complex tasks.
Vision systems get more and more popular in automation. Companies are going to need people to install them, set them up.
The new lab also is home to 16 programmable logic controller stations and a conveyor system. PLCs are robust industrial computers that control manufacturing processes. The conveyor unit exposes students to pneumatics, electronics, and mechanical components of automation.
You can see multiple step processes. And with our conveyor systems and all of that, you can see the product moving. You can make it move, change the speeds.
Students are responsible for installing the conveyor system as part of a class.
A lot of times in a company, they're going to tell you, hey, we need that conveyor, in this case, moved to this room by Thursday, and I'm running. It's a lot of pressure, and the best way to learn that really isn't from a book, it's really by doing.
You really have to document everything, realize how everything's interacting with itself and other pieces of the actual system.
Interns began wiring the lab over the summer, and two students installed the 16 PLC stations this fall.
That's a really good feeling to be able to like help the incoming students and students that are here that'll get to use this lab.
Bradley PLCs, we have Siemens PLCs, so we're exposing them to much of what they will see in industry.
All of these PLCs behind me here, they're all going to be networked together. So any computer in this room can network and connect to any other device in this room.
We recruited this whole class that came in now, these freshmen, without having that lab. So having that lab now is just going to add another layer of excitement because they can see all the learning stations, they can see the robots, they can see the conveyor system.
During students' first four semesters, the robotics major focuses on electronics, and the mechatronics track emphasizes electrical and mechanical aspects. The curriculum is similar for the last 2 years of study, and graduates of both automation programs are expected to enjoy the same result, a quality job.
This is a huge opportunity, a huge field. Personal opinion, I think it's going to skyrocket.
It's nice knowing that what you planned for going 3 or 4 years is actually coming to something. It's coming to fruition. You're getting a job. You're going to go out and make a career.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.